Good morning. This is Doug Jones with Buyers Realty. Many of my buyers are first-time home buyers. As a matter of fact, I say most of my buyers are first-time home buyers. And because of that, everything I tell them is completely new to them. Now, I want to talk about an impound account. Because people know that when they buy a house and they finance it, they've got a mortgage loan. Okay? But what they don't know sometimes is that some things maybe have to be paid through the loan, such as taxes and insurance. Sometimes they're not required. So sometimes a customer can have an impound account or no impound account. I'm going to give an example of a loan with an impound account, a purchase with an impound. This is a $500,000 purchase. Now, the reason I mention that is because the taxes, the real estate property taxes, are based off the purchase price. The interest rate of the loan, of course, is based off the loan. So in this example, a person gets a $400,000 loan. That means they put down 20%. Therefore, there's no mortgage insurance required, and in most cases, no impound required if they don't want to. So that customer could make a monthly payment every month of $2,027. Now, in California, two times a year, that person also has to make their real estate property tax payment. And in this case, because the tax is based off the purchase price, the annual tax is $6,250, and cut that in half is $3,125. So two times a year, they'll make a payment of $3,125 to the county. Also, there's homeowner insurance, fire insurance, damage insurance, that type of thing that's required. The lender requires that. And I just put a number of $900. The customer shops for that. You shop for that with your own agent. And then the agent calls us, we tell them how to set the impound up, and they have to make a payment. Now, in the next video, I'm going to explain how the impound's set up, because a lot of money has to go into the impound account to set it up so the bank can make these payments. But in this case, if there's no impound set up, the customer's paying $2,027 a month, but the customer still has to pay $900 a year or quarterly, however they work it out, on the insurance. Now, if that customer wants impounds, then the bank will make the tax payment for them. They'll make it twice a year, but they'll charge a customer $521 a month. And the same thing with the insurance. They'll pay it when it's due, but they'll charge the customer $75 a month. So a person paying the loan with impounds will pay monthly $2,623. Without impounds, they'll pay the loan company $2,027. So which is better? There's no answer. A lot of people like impounds. Some people don't like impounds. Some people set side accounts up for these things here, and then they pay it from there. Personally, especially when I was younger, I always preferred the impounds, because then I didn't have to worry about not having the money when it came due. So that's what I'm talking about today, an impound account. So if you hear the term impound account or an escrow account, that's what the bank is talking about. That's what the lender's talking about. That's what the realtor's talking about. They're talking about how you make your mortgage payment. And also, one more thing, if there's mortgage insurance, that is required to be impounded. And if there's mortgage insurance, chances are they're also going to require the others, the taxes and the insurance, to be impounded as well. So sometimes the buyer does not get a choice. Sometimes they have to do an impound. Anyway, so I just wanted to explain this morning what an impound account is. I'm Doug Jones, and next video I'm going to talk about how this is set up, because a lot of times you have to bring a lot of money in to the escrow to set the impound account up. So I'm Doug Jones at Buyers Realty, and if you find a subscribe button on the screen there, please take your finger, this finger here, and just push that button, okay? Or if you got a mouse, you click it, and that pushes a button. So I'm Doug Jones at Buyers Realty. Thanks.